Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine. I'm just fine, Eric. I'm supposed to be okay now, right? Because he's gone. And I never really felt how it was to have him as a father. Because I never knew the truth, and he only told us about it now. And I'm supposed to be happy. I should be happy now that nobody will be causing trouble for us again. My mother and I, our whole family is now free. I should be happy now.
Are you ready to come home?
Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor.
You're welcome.
Thanks, Doctor.
Finally, you're okay. Do you want to eat out first?
No, let's just go home.
Are you sure?
Yes.
It's pretty hot today. Are you sure you don't want to go somewhere else?
No, let's just go home.
Sure?
Yes.
Okay. Thanks again, Doctor. Finally, you're back home.
Why is she still here, Sigmund? Cassandra?
Eleanor?
Get out of my house! I said, get out of here!
Eleanor, that's enough! Stop it!
She's the one who drove me insane, Sigmund.
Here's a glass of juice. I made this specially for you. I'm telling the truth. There is something weird going on in this house. No. I believe you. Now, calm down and relax. Take these pills to relax your body and to clear your mind.
Do you think this will help?
It works for me.
Okay. Thank you, Cassandra.
You're welcome. Where are the medicines, Cassandra? I need them. I keep on dreaming of Daphne's death, and I haven't had an hour of sleep.
I'm sorry, Eleanor. I ran out of stock. I could have them deliver it, but then you'd have to wait. So, would you please get out of my room?
But I need it now. Not tomorrow. Not later today. I really need the medicines now, or else I'll go crazy!
Will you please stop, Eleanor? You're hurting me!
Then give me the damn medicine. I know that you use it yourself, so you have your own stash. I am warning you, Cassandra. I will get that medicine, even if I have to kill you. I don't want to have to see her face while I'm living in this house.
Eleanor, she's my daughter. She has a right to live in this house.
In that case, then I should be the one to go.
You can't leave me. You're my wife.
only on paper, but you never treated me like your own wife. When I was about to leave the hospital, I promised myself that I will never go back there. But I cannot keep my sanity around Cassandra. So, you choose, Sigmund. Me? Or your monster of a daughter?
Eleanor, don't force me to answer that question.
So I guess nothing has really changed in this house.
Did you see what happened to Harry? That was just bad luck, you know?
But what about the gambling?
You know, even though Harry's dead, the gambling goes on. As long as there are people like us who need it.
Let's just go. We don't belong here.
That's right.
This place meant a lot to my father.
Yes, but this is nothing like the port. This is even worse. This place is worse than a hellhole.
Come on, let's have some more drinks.
Okay, go ahead.
You know, I actually feel sorry for him.
Fill up my glass as well.
He never got a chance to change. Everyone knows that he's an evil man.
Remember what Harry told you right before he died? He wanted you to be happy. He's gone, Meningning, and you just have to accept that.
I could do with some food.
Cassandra has no reason to come after you anymore. Rosa is already in jail. You finally fulfilled the dreams you had for your family. I think now's the time for you to think of your own happiness. We have to think about our future now.
I brought you some food.
Sigmund? Thank you. I've called my lawyer. I'm filing for an annulment. I have forgiven you. But this doesn't mean that I have already forgotten the fact that you murdered my daughter Mayumi. And you ruined my life and Meningning's as well. But I need to forgive you. It's the only way for me to leave the past and start rebuilding my life with my family. I'm so glad that you're finally in jail.
Cassandra, my dear, your grandmother's thinking of leaving the country. I know that I still have to make up for the years that I was gone. Why don't you come with us? Just me, your grandmother, and you. It will help us move on. We can start a new life there. We can forget all the bad things that happened to us here.
Don't worry, you have nothing to make up for anymore. I've already caused you a lot of trouble. You and Grandmother can leave. Going away from here will be really good for you.
But it will be good for you too.
I don't think I can go away with you, Father. My family's here. I need to stay here and fix things between my sister and me. When I've done that, then I can think about joining you and Grandmother.
If you ever change your mind, your passport and ticket are ready. You will always be welcome, okay?
Thank you for still thinking of me. I will make you pay, Maningning. You're going to pay.
Only a year, 7 months, 4 days, 10 hours, and 30 minutes before I can taste freedom from this prison. Every day I count the days till I leave this hole. I keep feeling the same anger that I felt when I was first locked up in this place. But I try to forget about it, because I know that once I get out of here, I will finally see you, my daughter. Two months, 4 days, 10 hours, and 3 minutes to go before I get to be with you. But even with all the years I've spent thinking in this place, I still don't know if I'm ready to face the responsibility of being your father. I hope that you can still forgive me. I hope your mother can forgive me as well. But I don't know if I can. Forgive the man who had me locked up in this filthy place. I don't even know if I can forgive myself for what I did. My child, 4 days, 10 hours, and 30 minutes have passed since I was released from jail. My name, Ning. So that's your name. It's the most beautiful name I have ever heard.
How are you? Are you feeling better now? Are you sure you want to stay here? You can stay with me.
But my enemies will be too far from me if I come live with you.
It's time to start letting go. You have to forget about all those people, Elena. I don't want you to get hurt again.
This time, I'm going to do it right. They won't get away from me. I'm going to do it myself. The next time I get to hold a gun, one of them will die. Either my father or Meni Ning. Or at least I will get one of their loved ones. This time we're not going to be the losers.
I don't want to lose you, Elena. If it weren't for your baby, you'd be dead by now. I'm not saying that you should forget your anger. What I'm saying is, after all those things that happened to you, you should be more careful. You don't need to do all the dirty work. You don't have to. We can get someone else to do that. We can hire someone to kill those people for loose change.
I would rather do the work myself.
I know a lot of people.
We can't count on other people for this.
We can. There's Rosa.
Rosa? Are you that crazy, Auntie? Do you know why she's in jail right now? Because all her life, all she did was make mistakes.
Rosa is perfect for this. She has nothing to lose in her life anymore, Elena. I'm sure that she still wants revenge for what Meni Ning has done. See? She's already killed 4 people. She's been convicted. Her own son sent her to jail. What else does she have to lose by going out and killing another person?
But she can't do that if she's behind bars.
I'll help her escape. Better to have her do the dirty work than us.
Hey, look at that. Hey!
Hey, hey, give that back.
This is a lot.
Money.
You have a lot of money.
Give it to me, give it to me, let it go.
That's a lot of money. That's true.
No way, I can't.
Why not? What?
I'm saving up for something.
What?
What for? I'm saving so I can go with Sandy.
What? Yes!
So, when are you coming back? Are you leaving now, like right now?
What is this?
I can't let Sandy slip away from me again, okay? This is for Sandy. I'm going with her.
But when?
The minute I save up enough money. It won't be long now.
That's pretty exciting.
So you need a little more? Then here, take this money. You might need money for cab fare. We'll
yes,
take you to the airport. Is that okay?
Come on,
let's go.
Nah, not yet.
It's not your time.
That's right.
Today.
Hey, let me have some.
Are you guys
going to
miss
Come on.
What? Stop that.
Come on, how much is
you
that?
You can't
come on,
have
tell
my
us.
Money.
Hey,
stop it.
Don't stand around like that. Doesn't look nice. Come here. Tell me when you want to treat us out to a round of drinks. We'll throw you a farewell party, and then we'll get you a really sexy
chick. Come on, let's go to the airport.
I'll be going with Charles. We'll go and visit Rosa.
Okay.
Do you want to join us?
Now it's not the right time, Eric. This is not the right time for me to go and see Rosa. Charles, I hope you understand why I talk about her this way.
It's okay. I understand. I don't even want to see her right now. But I'm not doing this for her. I'm doing this for myself. I'm doing this for me and my brother.
You know, Mening-Ning, I feel so much pain every day. My own mother has hurt the people I love. She's killed our friends. And she caused a lot of pain to all of us. I can live with all of that, but I think of it every day. That's why Charles and I thought it would help if we go and face her, so we can deal with it. I told Charles that no matter how we try to deal with it, even if we turn our back on Rosa, or we pretend that she never did all of those things, she is still a murderer. And we can't get away from all that and all of the things that she's done to us. That's why we're doing this. And I think that you should do the same thing.
I know what you mean. But I can't do it right now, Eric.
Okay. Okay. Well, we'll be going now. Come on, Charles.
Okay.
Your husband took you back. And he's already accepted everything that has happened. Isn't that enough for you? Why are you leaving? Are you expecting your husband to finally show you some love?
Love was never an issue, Mother. Do you see all of this jewelry? Sigmund gave them to me. For these alone, I was already happy.
Then if you're happy, as you say you are, then tell me, why are you leaving?
Because whenever I see the face of that woman I saved, she nearly died at that moment, without anyone showing her how to be loved. And if Sigmund cannot give me the love that I am looking for, I am not going to force him, Mother. But as for me, I'm going to look for my own happiness.
Well, in that case, I wish you good luck. And I sincerely hope you will find what you're searching for.
Oh, thank you, Mother.
Here she is.
Please forgive me. My sons. Eric,
Eric. Please forgive me.
That's enough. That's
I'm
enough.
I'm sorry.
Please.
Charles. Baby boy. Baby boy. Baby boy, forgive me. I'm sorry.
You're always going out at night. Oh, my goodness. My goodness, what happened to you? Where did you hit your head? What happened? I'll call the doctor.
It's okay, Mother. Goodness. Fine. It's okay.
How can you say that? You look at yourself. You are not okay. Why are you doing this to yourself? Is it still because of what happened to Daphne? When are you going to stop doing this to yourself, Charles?
I'll keep doing this until I find the person that murdered my beloved wife. I have to find out what really happened. I want to know how this could happen to her. I will always be haunted by memories of my time with Daphne.
I promise you, Charles, we will find a person that killed Daphne. I'm going to help you find that murderer. I just miss our heart-to-heart talks.
But we don't have anything to talk about, do we?
Come on, son, I'm reaching out to you.
Fine, make it quick.
Well, I've noticed that you've been going out a lot to meet up with a friend. That you're always chatting with someone on your computer, baby boy. I want to know who this person is and why you're always talking. Are you opening your heart to someone?
No, Mother. Like you just said, I'm spending all this time with someone who's just a friend. So can you please go?
Well, whoever your friend is, I wish you were not just friends, but more than friends. I want you to be happy again. Good night, baby boy. Good morning, my baby boy. I'm so sorry. I couldn't wait up for you anymore. I peeked into your room earlier and you were sleeping so soundly, so I ate ahead. And Mom, can you bring a plate over here for my baby boy? You know, I have a feeling about today. It's going to be a beautiful day for every one of us.
Glad I caught you in a good mood. I'm sure you're going to enjoy what I'm about to ask you. How are you involved in Daphne's murder?
What?
You heard me. How are you involved in Daphne's murder?
What are you talking about? I am innocent after all, my baby boy. I know how painful it was for you when your wife died. And you know I don't want you hurting so bad. Besides, you don't have proof that I was involved, my baby boy. Whatever Eric said in court, baby boy, it's not true, okay? Not true.
I don't know who's telling the truth anymore, Mother, but at least Eric and Ning Ning aren't hiding anything from me, unlike you.
I will not hide anything from you.
Fine then. I'll be very frank with you. What is your connection to Victor, Cassandra, and Mayor Violeta? Do you know anything about Daphne's death? Do you know who murdered my wife?
I don't know!
Well, just know this. Sooner or later, the truth will come out, Mother.
Baby boy.
You were just going to run away from your problems? You didn't even want to face your own son.
Yes, I admit. I'm a bad person. I'm a bad mother to you. But I did not want to hurt you. I did not want to kill Daphne. I kept everything from you because I don't want to lose you. I don't want you to abandon me. I don't want to hurt you.
What do you know about pain, Mother? You have no idea what I'm going through right now.
I am so sorry. I'm so sorry.
I don't think I can ever forgive you. Even if I have to put you in jail, I will do it.
You don't have to send me to jail, son. Because it hurts me even more knowing you disown me. And I regret it! Stop me and bring me to jail. Now is your chance.
Eleanor.
I never expected that he will ever love me, Sigmund. Even before we got married, I've already accepted that. But when I got out of the hospital, I thought that it was time for me to start hoping that he can feel love for me. But then I realized I was wrong.
Are you sure you're not going to change your mind?
We've already wasted half of our lives doing this. And I can't live another day living like this. I don't want to waste my life like this. For whatever it's worth, thank you for everything. Let's go.
That looks really good.
Oh, yes.
Dried fish.
Oh, Charles!
Charles.
Good morning, Eric.
How are you?
Come in.
Come and eat. Come on in.
Come on, let's eat dinner. Join us here.
It's okay.
Come on, Charles. You want to join us?
It's all right. I do love dried fish. But I can't stay too long because I might be late for my flight.
But why? Where are you going?
I'll be joining my father again abroad. Actually, I've thought about it for some time now. After all, the house in the city is empty already.
You take care, okay?
Oh, Charles. Here's my shoe size. Get me some rubber shoes.
Eric?
Sure, no problem. Just promise me you won't do drugs. But Eric, before I leave, I need to ask you something.
What's that?
Do you think that we did the right thing when we went to visit our mother?
What did you feel, Charles, after seeing her?
I felt lighter, and I think that I can start a new life. I can now move on after losing Daphne.
Then we did the right thing.
I still won't be able to forget about Daphne, but life goes on, right? We have to move on.
Welcome here. If you're leaving, you might as well bring some food on the plane. You might get hungry. Eric already gave you some to bring to work, right? I hope you like
this. Thank you.
I don't think you can bring that on the plane.
And why not? Since when have they told people that they can't bring food on
because
the plane?
Because it smells bad?
Thank you very much, Rudy.
Charles, we're all going to miss you.
Remember that we all love you here, Charles. And if you ever need a place to stay here, you can stay here in my place. You're always welcome to stay here with us.
Thank you so much, Virgie. What do you mean?
Brother.
You all take care, okay?
You take care of yourself.
Take care.
How about that? Don't do drugs, okay?
Okay.
Tell them all about our delicious food here. Where are you going again? Abroad?
Abroad.
Right.
Yes.
Call us, okay?
Of course.
Take care.
Take care of yourself, okay?
I will. Thanks again.
You know, Charles is such a decent young man. Not at all like his mother.
Here, want some chocolate?
Winnie, it's expensive. Go on, take it. We'll eat it later when we get home.
Thank you so much.
Myself. I've been doing this all.
Ow! Watch it.
If I tell you my name, mister, will you quit pestering me, huh?
Yes.
Maning Ning.
Maning Ning?
What?
Charles, that's my name. Charles.
I brought you a snack.
Thank you, but I still have to finish this.
Okay, let me see if I can help.
Hey, no, wait, don't do that, don't touch that. Don't try to help me. What if your mother sees this here? She might get mad at me. I can get fired, you know? Besides, you'll only slow me down even more. See, you don't even know how to do it.
It's broken. I knew this umbrella was broken.
It's inside out. Eric? Eric, what are you doing here? Eric, what are you doing? What's wrong with you?
I didn't know I had such a jealous boyfriend. But it's okay. He didn't hit me that hard anyway.
Charles?
Daphne?
You? I'll be going ahead, okay? Thanks for taking me home.
Thank you for letting me take you home.
So what are you waiting for? Go home.
No, it's okay. I'll stay here. And keep an eye on you.
Is that so?
Yes.
Okay. Then I'll go ahead.
Alright.
Are you going to be okay?
I'll be fine.
Okay.
Let me taste it. I'll be the judge.
Are you sure about that? I'm warning you, it's really salty.
Is it hot?
Here. See, I told you. Hey, Charles.
I was thinking of inviting you to go out. Come on, let's go.
Go out? Oh, I actually have plans with Eric.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Is it a date? Why? Have you gotten back together?
The thing is, I just haven't told him this yet. But I'm planning on getting back together with him. I don't know. I can't help it. I just love him so much.
Oh. Well, thanks for your time, okay? Morning, Ning.
What now? Have you forgotten what I told you? Didn't I tell you to stop bothering me?
This won't take too long. I just wanted to talk to you about something.
What for? When she finds out, Daphne will get mad. And I just found out. I heard you two are going to get married soon.
Meningning, I really don't love her. It's you. I love you. And you're the one I want to marry.
Goodness, Charles, please. Stop it. You're going to be married to Daphne. You two are going to have a child. So do me a favor. Stop following me around. It's not right for you to fall in love with me.
I will leave Daphne just to be with you. But it's not Daphne that I'm in love with.
You know what, Charles? Sometimes there is a kind of love that you don't instantly feel for someone. Sometimes you'll just have to teach your heart who to love and who to care for.
Daphne, even if we don't end up together, at least let me take care of you and the baby. And please, forgive me for what I've done to you. Please give me another chance. You know, Eric, you're really lucky to have my name. So take care of her, or I'll beat you up.
Really, is that so? I know I'm very lucky to have my name. So leave her alone, or I'm going to have to beat you up.
We really are brothers. We fell in love with the same girl. This is probably the stupidest thing I'll ever do in my entire life. Go. She's over there, waiting for you.
See you, Charles.
See you, Eric.